Oh. Good morning, everyone. I am Grimwit. This is Miasmata. It's a fresh day. So what are we going to do with it? We're going to head north into unknown country. Around here-ish. Where's the stairs? There's the stairs. Today there will be a lot of exploring places we don't know or understand. Past the evil pearl mushroom. Too gray in the morning on Eden. Might as well just head straight north. The presence of animals, I think I've mentioned, is a good sign, and it makes me feel safe going off into the middle of nowhere. Sorry about that. Sometimes I mistake buttons. How about a little fire, Scarecrow? I'm not sure if it's helping or hindering my progress. The trouble is, it's very dark in the morning. I should have done something before I left. Gave the sun a little time to catch up with me. Whoa! That wasn't as bad as it seemed. Also, fire can be useful. When we find ourselves next to a... I don't even know what to call those landmarks where you just set it on fire and it saves. Pillars? I found a trail accidentally. If it is a trail. Oh, this is a trail. And it leads... Welcome to the most secluded campsite, and the hardest to map. It's hidden behind this big rock. Look at that. So how does one map this damn thing? Silverware. You'd think Robert Hughes would pick up the silverware. If he could attack the creature with the banana, he should be able to do the same with a fork. Just saying. I could go around these rocks to the left, but I can swim now, so let's take a dip. It's been a while since we had a good bath. Ah, seawater, full of electrolytes. Too many electrolytes. Ah. Well, that's not nothing, but it's not what I can use. I can just add a couple of things, but I don't think I will be able to map that secluded camp. Ah, well. Perhaps if I go to that peninsula way over there. Even then, it feels like a long shot. theoretically, we should be able to see a giant stone head or landmark clear across the island. Oddly enough, I can't find how big the island is. You would think that would be a statistic somebody would measure. Lord knows there's enough maps. Perhaps next episode we're gonna see how far Robert Hughes can run now that his endurance is set to normal. Let's see. That damn rock's in the way again. I might have to go all the way to the head. What? Never mind. Still can't quite see any landmarks. Oh well, who needs maps anyway? I accidentally found another path. Whoa, you're new. Check you out in due time. For some reason, that root reminds me a little bit of a beetle. Maybe Ringo? George? I don't know. Another ruined temple. I think it's a ruined temple. Whoever lived on this island before we visited must have been very good architects. It's hard to do an arch, a stone arch. And it's even more impressive that that's one of the only pieces of the structure that's still here. Nope. Oh, come on, Robert. You could handle that. Such a small fall. Small fall. Whoa. Doing the Let's Play for this game has made me get a different kind of wanderlust. I'm always playing games on the side, as I'm sure any other Let's Player would be. I recently got a hold of Mirror Moon, which is like Miasmata on crack. Or maybe acid, LSD, feels that way. But it's along that kind of same lines. You start off immediately with no whoa-oh. Now would be a good time to be thirsty. Hello, creature. I don't think he saw us. Oh good, I don't have to get this route again. I saw something very bright blue off in the distance. Hi. Blue, scaly fungus. Looks vaguely familiar. So yeah, Mirror Moon's another one of those setups where they don't give you any information. But worse, they don't even give you instructions on how to play the game or what buttons do what. With some small exception. Whereas Miasmata is more than fair, Mirror Moon is not fair. Ultimately, though, they are both games about exploration. I guess that's one similarity. Hello, bird. Oh. That was handy. Alright, what do you do, Root? Energy stimulant. Do not need you. Nope, don't need you. Goodbye. And what do you do, fungus? It's another ingredient for the cure. Not the band, the actual cure. There it is. Its counterpart that creates Agent X is actually nearby. And by nearby, I mean not even near where we are, but at least on the same side of the island. We've actually been there before. We even found notes about it. Lunchia from the forum had asked about this particular plant. Well, good news. We're gonna go find it. Since we can swim now, it's actually gonna be something we can get a hold of. And it's right here, in this little crescent river. Getting to it. I guess we have to head straight southwest. That pillar, save, get prepared. Let's go exploring. Into the wild unknown. Unlike the beaches to the north, we'll be able to easily map our way. I want this thing. I want this thing too. That's two things I want. I need to research this thing. Ah, this thing is basic medicine. We'll use this thing later. Now, where was I? Off into the wild unknown. Mutual of Omaha presents I'm Lost and I'm Dying of the Plague. Brought to you by a grant from the Robert Hughes Foundation and viewers like you. I need to get up there somehow. Up there is where adventure is. Hydrophobia practically cured, still won't protect us from falling off a cliff. No, that's not a good sign. Oh, no. Okay, That could have gone better. That's all right. We'll find a different foothold. Unfortunately, I could not tell you if raising Robert Hughes' strength will make his climbing better. That would be nice, but I don't think that's the way it works. My impeccable sense of direction is telling me to head down. That's not right. I certainly hope no creatures saw that. That would have been embarrassing. Wait a second, I recognize those steps in the distance. I know where those flowers are, and I may be off track a little. But I don't see the telltale trail that usually tells me where I am. I am headed in the right direction. I'm lost. And that is clearly the bay. Figure out just where I ended up. I'm too far west. Okay, easy to fix. We know where we are. We'll just head straight east. Problem solved. There are times when my footfalls on the stone sound like a heartbeat. Just two in a row. Boom, boom. And I immediately duck. Phantom heartbeats. I should be able to handle this. We'll just take it slow and run into as many trees as possible. Huh. Okay. Oh, I made it. Towards the blue clouds. No, the clouds are white. It's the sky that's blue. Beg my pardon. I shouldn't really need to do this. I got a good idea where I am. I'm right next to the very strange, creepy statue. Yep. Should have filled up on water before I left. There we are. It's delicious. Stick it right into my forehead. And here we are again. This time not dilly-dallying. We're here on business. Before, we tried to avoid the water. Now we don't have to. I'm not certain how far Robert Hughes can swim before his strength runs out. But he should be able to handle all of this. The Though it doesn't show it, drinking from freshwater ponds like this does fill up our canteen. Every now and then, maybe at random, Robert Hughes will actually show the canteen being filled. Oh, so much water. Everywhere. I feel like I need to make a diver joke. The one who is married to all the fish. A little cartography might help a little later on, but it wouldn't do us much good here. Let's try it at the next point. There are plenty of landmarks. It actually makes me wonder, what was this place? What was it used for? Now, this is a question I've asked before, and I'm going to ask again. Why was this place built? How many gods did the civilization on Eden have? Why do they need so many temples? Why were they so good at constructing arches? We have time. If it didn't take me so long to get here, I'd jump straight into the water, just off the cliff, to see what would happen. Ah! Our goal. It's prettier in real life. And it does smell like a banana and strawberry smoothie. Okay, we have two choices. We can risk just going off into the sunset, trying to find our way back by pure luck. I believe there's even a tent nearby. Yep, there it is, at the very, very edge. Or we can head back the way we came and go back to Outpost Dow. Well, since I haven't saved in a while, and there's supposed to be a pillar to save around here, but I don't see it, I'm going to take the safe route. At this point, I am thinking about heading west again, but it doesn't happen. I take the safe route. If you're playing along, you may find a different statue that looks exactly like the creepy statue back there. In fact, you might want to just explore around this area. Maybe you can glean some clues as to its purpose, because I'll be damned if I know what's going on here. There are too many ceremonial and religious-like structures on this island. I don't see any form of municipal buildings. Pretty view. So long, Crescent River. Strange structure of unknown use and type. Now that I have this plant, my biggest worry is meeting the creature on the way back. I may have already triggered him while trying to climb up here earlier. Don't know. But he's not around now. So let's go running. Chariots of Fire theme here. So what do you do, plant? I already know you're part of the cure. The third of six. We now have half of the cure. Of course I'm thirsty. Why wouldn't I be thirsty right now? Not good, this. Water, a great, great beverage. It's hard to believe. This is the first time we're going to get one of the three agents. Take it slow. Enjoy it. Savor the celebration. Get angry and frustrated if it doesn't work. Use the same chemicals I always have and put it on this Bunsen burner for no reason. There it is. Agent X. It appears in our journal right there. And that's it. It's a good episode today. And I'll see you guys next time. Stay tranquil, everyone.